this is in continuation to our previous video lecture where we were looking at the rules of naming branched chain alkanes, right? So we were at rule 6, right? Rule 6, where we were looking at the carbon atoms, right? Carbon chain that has this kind of side chain. Carbon atom of the branch, right, attached to the root alkane is numbered 1, right? This is the root alkane, right? I'm sorry, I have just CH2, then you have CH3. This is nonane, like we named it before, right? So root alkane is nonane, N-O-N, right? I'm just doing it again, right? So suffix, what type of carbon atoms? A-N-E. Carbon-carbon, single bond, so A-N-E. Now, this will go in prefix, right? So how will you name it, right? This is a long chain, right? It should have naming of its own, right? So how will you name it? Firstly, prefix, right? We are finding prefix for this compound, right? This is present at 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, right, 9, right? So this is present at 5th carbonate, right? So prefix would be, I'll just show you how to derive prefix, because this will go in prefix. 5, this prefix, this side chain is present at 5th carbon atom, right? Dash, then you put a bracket. To name this, you put a bracket. Now, the rule says carbon atom of the branch attached to the root alkane is numbered 1. So carbon atom, this is the branch, this is the carbon atom of the branch which is attached to the root alkane. This is the root alkane, so we'll number it 1. This is 2, this is 3, right? So how will you name it? The carbon atom 2. If you look at this, this is connected to 2 methyl groups. If you look at the straight chain, which is the longest chain, is 1, 2, 3 of 3 carbon atoms, right? So it would be 2 methyl groups at 2nd carbon atom of this chain. So 2, comma 2 dimethyl, right? 1, 2, 3, this is propyl, right? 2, 2 dimethyl, right? This chain consists of 3 carbon atoms, propyl, right? This is the name of prefix. So how will you name this organic compound? First rule, longest chain is identified, which is this 9 carbon atoms, NON. Second rule says, for suffix, what is the nature of carbon-carbon bonds? Single bonds, A-N-E, right? Then you have a side chain, right? This is numbered at number 5 carbon atom. So we have seen how to name it, right? So it would be, this is the prefix, right? So how will you name it? Just remember how I did this. 5 indicates this side chain, then hyphen, then you have a bracket. I'll put the name of this in this bracket, in this parenthesis. So, right, so it would be 5, 2, 2, right? You have 2 methyl groups. We have seen this, how to name it, right? You have a dash between this, dimethyl, propyl, nonane. This is how will you name it, right? Now, the seventh rule. The seventh rule talks about the functional groups, right? Now, what rules do we need to consider if you have a functional group, right? Functional group has its own rules. First thing that you should know is that functional group comes under suffix. It comes under suffix. So if you have prefix, word root, plus suffix, right? So functional group will come in suffix. So the rule for functional group would be the numbering. When you do this kind of numbering, and you if you have a functional group as one of the substituent, then numbering should be started from the side so that the functional group will get a lowest number, like we were doing for side chains. the side chains should get lower number. Now, if you have, say, functional group also, then the numbering will start giving preference to functional group, right? The numbering will start so that that functional group will get a lower number, right? And if you have, say, more than one functional group, right? If you have two functional groups, say, alcohol and ketone, right? Then there is an order, right? There is an order of priority of functional group, which functional group should be given priority, right? So the functional group that has a higher priority, there is an order, I'll just write it down. The functional group that has a higher priority will be treated as a principal functional group. Now all the rules of, like I said, that lower number should be given to the principal, it should be given to the functional group. Now if you have two functional groups and a functional group that has a higher priority, right, that would be called as a principal functional group. Now all rules will apply to the principal functional group, that is the numbering rule and the suffix rule, right? In the suffix, the principal functional group will grow and the other functional group will go in prefix, right? So for functional groups, numbering should start so that functional group, let me write it like this, functional group or principal functional group, right? If you have two functional groups, should get lower number. Right, now there is an order of functional groups. Remember that double bonds and triple bonds, right, are also functional groups, right? So order is COOH, right? Then you have SO3H, then you have COOR, right? Then you have COCl, you have CONH2, you have CN, HCO, then you have this ketone group, then you have OH group, NH2 group, then you have double bond, and then you have triple bond. This is the order, right? Now as I said, that the functional group that has a higher priority, as you go move along this series, the priority is going down, right? So this this carboxylic group has highest priority in this series, right? This COOH group, this has highest priority. And this has the lowest priority, right? And this priority is going down as you move along the series, right? So if suppose I have two functional groups in an organic compound, right? I have two functional groups. One is your OH group, the other is keto group, right? Which would be the principal functional group, right? This is a ketone group and this is an OH group. Ketone group comes first, right? So ketone group, this would be treated as principal functional group and this would be treated as functional group, right? This will go in suffix here and this will go in prefix, right? Now, how will you name it? You will name it as hydroxy prefix alkanone suffix. This is prefix, this is prefix, this is suffix. This is how you will name it. Let's just take an example. You have a compound. You have a compound named एच ओ सी एच टू, देन यू हैव सी एच टू होल थ्राइस, देन यू हैव सी एच टू सी ओ सी एच टू सी ओ सी एच थ्री, राइट. नाउ दिस इज अ कीटोन ग्रुप, आई जस्ट राइट इट डाउन लाइक दिस. दिस इज अ कीटोन ग्रुप, राइट, एंड दिस इज अ ओ एच ग्रुप, राइट. हाउ विल यू नेम इट? सो विच इज अ प्रिंसिपल फंक्शनल ग्रुप बेस्ड ऑन दिस? कीटोन ग्रुप हैज अ हायर प्रायोरिटी, सो प्रिंसिपल फंक्शनल ग्रुप वुड बी दिस. सो ऑल रूल्स विल अप्लाई टू इट, द नंबरिंग रूल एंड द सफिक्स रूल. सो कीटोन ग्रुप, दिस ग्रुप विल गो इन सफिक्स, राइट, एंड नंबरिंग शुड स्टार्ट सो दैट दिस कीटोन ग्रुप विल गेट अ लोअर नंबर, 1, 2, 3, राइट. दिस इज 4, 5, 6, वी हैव 3 सी एच टू ग्रुप, सो 4, 5, you will get 4, 5, 6, then you have 7, right. Now since this is the other less prior functional group, OH group, this will go in prefix. So how will you name it? 1, 2, 3, 7 carbon atoms, this is the longest chain, 7 carbon atoms, hept. Nature of carbon atoms, you have all single bonds in, right, and you have ketone group, right. Ketone group, you will name it as, ketone group is named as keto, or you can name it as oxo, right. Now remember the rule of primary suffix and secondary suffix that we did before, right, in the previous video lecture. Right, that is important here. Right, when you have a secondary suffix, right, which is your functional group, that if it starts with vowel sound, A E I O U, right, it starts with O, then you will drop E from the primary suffix. Right, so here I will drop this E, it will remain as A N. Why? Because the secondary suffix starts with a vowel sound, right. And what would be the prefix? Since you have OH group here, so this OH group will come in prefix, right, and its position is 7, it would be 7OL, right. For alcohol you put OL, right. So how will you name it? It is hydroxy prefix, right. First the order prefix should come 7 hydroxy, right, then your word root will come heptan, right, without E, remember, right. You have 7 hydroxy hept word root, then this en E is dropped because this secondary suffix starts with vowel sound O, heptan, right, heptan, then secondary suffix, right, it's at position 2, right. So it would be, if you name it, it would be 2-on, right. I'm sorry, it's O-N-E, you can use O-N-E, right, for wherever you see this alkanones, we call these as alkanones, right, we call these as alkanones, right, which is a ketone group. So if you have a ketone group, you can put O-N-E. So here, since primary suffix group is a ketone group, which we put O-N-E for ketone group, so it is O-N-E over here. So the position is 2, heptan, 2-on, this is the name of the compound. Right, it's heptan 2-on. Right, this is the name of the compound. Now let's look at one more compound, right, that will help us to understand it better. And remember, if you have R, if you have C6H5, or if you have any halogen, right? If you have methyl, if you have benzyl, C6H5, or you, if you have any halogen, it will always go in prefix. If you have ethoxy, methoxy, these kind of side chain or substituents, these will always go in prefix, right? Now the compound that you have is, it's BrCH2CH, it's BrCH2, right? BrCH2CH double bond CH2, right? Remember this series, right? And remember, double bond and triple bonds are functional groups, right? So here numbering will start. So which one? You have just one functional group here, right? And this Br is a side chain, right? So this is a functional group. Now this chain will number such that this should get lower number, right? We'll start it from, if I'll start it from here, it will get 1, 2, it will get number 2, right? So if I start it from here, this double bond, which is a functional group, will get lower number 1. So I'll start it from here, 1, 2, 3, right? Now, prefix, word root, suffix. Functional group is double bond, ene, right? Firstly, let's look at the word root. Word root is 3, P-R-O-P, right? Plus, now, what is the nature of carbon-carbon bond? It's double bond, right? So you have to specify in suffix. Why suffix? Because firstly it tells you the nature of carbon-carbon bond, which is a double bond, and it also tells you that it's a functional group, right? So it's ene, 1-ene. You need to specify the position, 1-ene. Bromo, right? I said halogens always go as prefix, right? So position is 3-bromo. Name is 3-bromo-propene, right? 3-bromo-prop, you have to specify the position, 3-bromo-prop-1-ene. This is how you will name it. Right, so this is it. Now we'll just quickly look at the naming of cycloalkanes. Right, cycloalkanes, instead of straight chains, right, or branched chains, now the first and the last carbon atom in cycloalkanes are joined to form a cycle. Right, so you have different cycles, right, based on the polygon structures that we did, right? You need minimum of 3 carbon atoms to form a chain, right? So it may be a it may be a cyclopropane, right? Starting from propane, you can have a cyclic alkane, right? So it may be a cyclopropane, cyclobutane, cyclopentane, cyclohexane, right? These kind of compounds are cycloalkanes. Let's quickly look at the naming convention of these cycloalkanes. Right, so if you have a saturated, since we are looking at saturated hydrocarbons only, you have cyclic compounds. Right, so if you have a cyclic compound, right, you need to put a prefix cyclo, right, before the name of the compound, right? So if I have, what I'm basically doing is I'm just drawing lines, right? So what is this? This is a polygon formula that represents a pentagon, right? So this, you have how many carbon atoms? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. This is pentane, right? This is pentane. Since you have a cycle, you will name it as cyclopentane, right? This compound is cyclopentane, no space, one word, cyclopentane, right? And what does these intersections represent? CH2. All these are CH2, right? So this is your cyclopentane. You prefix cyclo before the name of the straight chain. You have a chain of, it's kind of a chain. You have five carbon atoms. It's not like this, right? It's not like straight chain, but it's where first and second carbon atoms are connected. Then here first and last carbon atoms are connected to form this kind of a cycle, which is a cyclopentane, right? So this is your cyclopentane. Since you have a cycle, so you prefix it with cyclo. Now if you have a side chain, then you will apply these rules, right? Let's take example of a compound. Right, this compound, how will you name it? To name this compound, first right, we know that if in line notation, if this is line notation, these intersection represent CH2 group and these ends represent CH3 group. Right, this represents CH2. We have done this in the naming in the classification or in bond line notation that we have done in previous video lectures. Right, so first rule says longest chain. In cyclic compounds also you have to follow the same rule, right? So it would be, and you have a side chain, right? You have these side chains. This is the side chain, right? So you will start numbering the chain 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So the longest cyclic chain consists of 6 carbon atoms, right? And numbering I've started in this direction here, in this way, not here. Why? Because if I started from here, the side chain will get a bigger number. So we have to follow this rule. We should start numbering from the direction from the side where this side chains will get lower numbers, right? So if I started from here 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, it will get number 5. But if I started from here 1, 2, 3, it will get a lower number 3, right? And what will this represent? This is also a side chain. This is also a side chain, right? So remember, you have, this is your CH2, this is your CH2, this is your CH3. 3 carbon atoms, this is propyl, right? These are side chains, are nothing but alkyl groups, right? Like we followed here, same is followed here. And this is what this dash, what does this dash represent? This is your CH3 group, right? This is your CH3. This is what it represents. Now how will you name it? You have 2 alkyl groups, right? So numbering will start. First, which alkyl group will come, right? Because ethyl comes first, right, in alphabetical order, right? So this, it would be like this: 3 ethyl, 1 methyl hexane. 3 ethyl, 1 methyl cyclohexane. This is the name of the compound. Or now this rule we have done before, right? This is propyl. I said ethyl. This is your propyl. I was just confused it with ethyl. This is your 3 carbon atoms. Like I said in the beginning, this is your propyl, right? And this is your methyl, right? So alphabetically, P comes first, right? So name is 3-propyl. Name would be M comes first, MNOP, so M comes first, 1 methyl, right, 3 propyl, cyclohexane, this is the name of the compound, right. Now if you have, let's take example of some other compound. Here, right? It's the same compound. Remember these side chains. It would be treated same as per these rules. Side chains are nothing but these are alkyl groups, right? So this end represents CH3. This will represent CH3, this intersection represents CH2, this represents CH3. Now we will start numbering, right, such that these side chains should get lower numbers, right, and lowest sum rule, right. If I started from here, this side, then this will get 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So 1 plus 5, 6. This is the sum. Right, and if I started from here, 1, 2, 3, 1 plus 3, 4, which is lower? This. So if I started from here, these side chains are getting lower number and we are following lowest sum rule. So this, we will follow this. Right, word root is hex. We have, this is a saturated hydrocarbon, which is an alkane plus ANE. Right, now these side chains, we know that side chains go in prefix, right, as per this prefix. So how will we name it? This is your ethyl, this is your methyl. E comes first, so this would be 3-ethyl-1,1-dimethyl. 3-ethyl-1,1-dimethyl. This is how you will name it. Right, 3-ethyl-1,1-dimethyl. This comes in prefix. 3-ethyl. Make sure you put, you put a dash. 3-ethyl. Right, then 1,1 comma between 1,1. Right. You have, 1. Right, 3-ethyl, then put a dash, right, then we will name this 1,1-dimethyl, right, I'll write it over here, 3-ethyl, E-T-H-Y-L, hyphen, 1,1-dimethyl, right, hexane, this is how you will name it. Cyclohexane, right? You have a cyclo here. Always put cyclo before the name of the word root. Word root is, if you have a cycle, just instead of it, in this case, word root you can take as not hex but cyclohexane, cyclohex, right? Because anyway, you have to put cyclo if it's a cyclic compound, right? So the name would be, if you look at this, 3-ethyl-1,1-dimethyl cyclohexane. Why ethyl first? Because E comes before in alphabetical order. 3-ethyl-1,1-dimethyl cyclohexane, right? I hope all this is clear to you, right? You just need to practice. Let's practice some more straight chain, branched chain and cycloalkanes so that you get familiar with all these rules of functional groups, right? And these side chains, how to number these, name these. Thanks.